It's good to be here this morning. It's not very often, I don't think, that, you know, church falls on Christmas morning or Christmas Day. But, you know, I've already had a really good time this morning with the Lord at the house. And, you know, I was reading the Christmas story and, you know, just the short take of it in Matthew. And, you know, I started to think about all the things that I'm thankful for and how blessed I am and how blessed we are that the Lord sent down His Son to save us from our sins. And I just got a song that I've recently learned, and I want to sing it for you, and I hope it blesses your heart like it's blessed mine.
Can you give me a G chord? Can you give me a G chord?
For a long time I've traveled down a long, lonely road. My heart was so heavy, in sin I sank low. Then I heard about Jesus. What a wonderful hour. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I'm so glad that I found out and He brought me out by His saving power. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. I'm washed in the blood. I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out and He brought me out by His saving grace. Like a bird out of prison that's just taken flight. Like a blind man that God gave back His sight. Like a poor wretched beggar that's found fortune and fame. I'm so glad that I found out and He brought me out by His saving grace. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. I'm washed in the blood. I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. Sing it, church. I'm glad that He showed me the way. Amen. That's all I got, preacher.
Amen. That's all you got, that's all you need, amen. I'm glad that I found out, amen, He could bring me out of this world of sin, amen. So glad to see everyone in the house of the Lord. What a great looking congregation on a Christmas morning. Merry Christmas to each one. And so glad God has brought us together for this hour of worship. Amen. Let's get our Bibles this morning and turn to that familiar story in Luke chapter 2 this morning. Luke chapter 2. Amen. You feel free to worship the Lord just like you see necessary this morning. Amen. I see some worshiping. Amen. Luke chapter 2, of course, we'll begin right there in verse number 1, amen. My little heading there in chapter 2 says, the birth of Jesus, amen. And that's what we are celebrating today. No matter how anybody wants to twist it or turn it, we are celebrating the birth of our Savior, amen. And we have chosen this day, and I'm so glad that I found out that He could bring me out by His saving power, amen, amen. Bible says in verse number 1, I like to say before I begin to read that I don't know anything about 1969 or before. Know nothing about it because I was born in 1970. And I don't know if I'll know anything about 2023 because I might not make it. But I'm so glad of this day that God's given us. Amen. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. What we got to realize is God's give us today. Amen. And he's give us right now. And when we read things like this in the Bible, it was just a day just like this day. And it says it in verse number 1, and it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was while they were there that her days would to be accomplished, that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, an angel came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, and you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards men. And it came to pass that the angels were gone away from them unto heaven, and the shepherds said one to another, let us go even unto Bethlehem to see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the sayings which was told concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at the things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them. Amen. May God add his blessing to the reading of his word. We love you today, God, and we thank you, Lord, that you've allowed us to come to your house on this special day, this Christmas morning, this day that you give us, oh God, and we thank you for that. I thank you for everyone present here, God. I pray for each soul that's represented today, God, that you'll be sweet blessings on them. God, bless them in their life, I pray, God, in every way, and we'll thank you for all that you do, and we'll give you the praise and glory for it all. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Amen. I pray everybody got the gifts they want for Christmas. Amen. I always liked, as a child, looking forward to Christmas because the gifts that I was planning on getting. Amen. And what Christmas brought was what I was excited about as a child, excited about getting gifts. Amen. Anybody like getting gifts? Amen. Everybody, you ain't got to be a child to like to get gifts. And this morning, as we read the first Christmas, amen, and that day, we celebrating it today because of that day. But I want to say what Christmas brings. That's what I want to preach this morning. What Christmas brings. Amen. That's our title this morning. And we see that I want to take up right here in verse number 13 and 14 and look back in it and see what Christmas brings. It says, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards men. Amen. Hey, I want to say that they come to tell the shepherds about the birth of Jesus Christ. They come to make an acclamation. Amen. They come to acclaim that Jesus Christ was being born and they need to go see it. And that acclamation, when they got talking about that Jesus Christ was born, it got so good to them. Amen. I don't know how many angels was there, but when they showed up, one angel's enough to terrify anybody, but there was enough of them showed up that the shepherds were scared, but other angels come in behind him when they started talking about there's going to be a child born, amen, that there's going to be a child born, he's going to be the savior of the world. And when the angels started saying that, all of, a host come in behind him and started saying, woo, glory to God, amen. And I was thinking about that, Brother Wayne, and I said an acclamation, an acclamation that we see right here in verse number 13 brought a celebration, amen. It brought a celebration. When you start talking about Jesus Christ, you can't help but start celebrating, amen. Brother Hunter was just trying to sing about how he brought him out and got a little happy about it, amen. Started celebrating in his soul about a birth of a Savior, Jesus Christ, amen. An acclamation that brought celebration. I don't know about how it really goes in heaven, and you don't either, but we know the angels are there. God sends them down here for purposes. God sends them down here to bring messages, and God brought them down here that day to bring that message that Christ was being born. And the angels got so happy they had to celebrate about it. And I thought about it, you know, I don't know how it goes, but there's got to be some conversation in heaven, amen. Hey, John said in Revelation, he said, and I heard a voice say, amen, there's some conversation going on in heaven, and I don't know how the angels exactly feel, but you know, they don't need to be redeemed because they have never failed, amen. They've seen angels fall, but they've never failed, so they don't know what redemption feels like, but there must be some conversation going on, and maybe God saying, hey, son, I want you to go down there and die for my people that they may have a way to get back to me. And the angel says, I don't know what it feels like to be fallen, but I know one thing. It makes God happy to know that he's making a way for his people. Huh? Hey, they said, I see God get happy, and it makes me happy. Amen. They said they was glorifying God and saying peace on earth and goodwill towards men. Amen. An acclamation I see that brought celebration. Amen. An acclamation that brings celebration. But I want us to be real this morning. And we celebrating Christmas and we're happy this morning. And we thank God for sending his son. But I want us to know in the Bible that God sent Jesus Christ here because he loves us that much. He loves you that much that he would send his own son to this earth to die for you. And I want us to know that these angels knew what was going on. And they were celebrating because God was going to be happy that he was going to redeem his people. What a good thing it is that God would send his only son. Paid a way for you and I. And the angel said, oh, this is a good thing. And they were celebrating, they were celebrating, they were celebrating. But it didn't take but one more chapter, Brother David. Hey, it didn't take but one more chapter for the angels to say, hey, Joseph, Joseph, get the child and get out of town. Huh, the celebration, you know how it is. If you're really celebrating something, it always ends too soon, don't it, huh? Oh, I wish we'd have had a whole nother day of that, amen. Hey, y'all know your birthday parties you used to have, they were over too quick. You get to go on vacation, you'd be gone for a week, but it still happened too quick. And the celebration we see ended because they have to tell, just in one chapter, tell Joseph, get out of town. They're trying to kill Jesus Christ as a little baby. You would see in another chapter, you would see that Jesus Christ would go to the wilderness to pray, and the devil would start lying on the angels. Hey, yes, he did. He would start lying on them, and then the angels would have to come and minister unto Jesus Christ. He first had to tell them to get out of town, then they had to come to him when he was getting tempted. And then we see in Luke 22, we can see that when he went into the garden to pray, not my will, but thine be done. The angels had to come and minister unto him when his sweat became as great drops of blood. We see the celebration had ended because he had to get out of town. He had to had to get tempted, and now he's going in the garden to pray. And we see in Matthew 26, he was going to Golgotha. They come to get him out of the garden to take him to Golgotha. And Peter said, you ain't taking my Lord. And he cut the man's ear off. And Peter would look at him and say, no, Peter. He that liveth by the sword dieth by the sword. And looked at him and say, Peter. Peter didn't want him to go and be crucified. But he said, Peter, don't you know that my Father would send more than 12 legions of angels if I would call? That celebration, now they have to come and They have to come and warn him to get out of town. Hey, they have to come and help him when he gets tempted. They have to go in the garden when he's praying. And now he says that they can come when he's on his way to Golgotha. Y'all heard it said before, and I've heard it said, and it's still vividly in my mind. When Jesus Christ was walking up the Via Della Rosa, he was going up that way to the place of the skull to be crucified, carrying his cross. Hey, that the angels in heaven, I don't know how it went, but one preacher said, I believe God had him with a big old chain like you'd hold back a ravening dog, and them angels wanted to come and rescue Jesus Christ, but he would never call. The angels' celebration ended because he had to get out of town. They was trying to kill him as a baby. He was getting tempted. He was in the Garden of Gethsemane, and he was going to Golgotha, and they had to come to him. But I want to say something, that the angels knew it wasn't going to end there, amen, because they would crucify Jesus Christ on Calvary, hey, and they would put him in the grave, but on day three, hey, he rose again, amen, and guess what God said, I know y'all been waiting on this, y'all going down there to help them people out, and said the angels had to come and roll away the stone, and then when he got the stone rolled away, and he sat on top of it. And them ladies come to the tomb and they run to it, and first thing they seen was an angel sitting there. And then when they finally got into the tomb, they seen two more angels sitting there. And they were celebrating. They said, that one who was dead is alive again. He's not here in this grave. That acclamation that brought celebration. And they celebrating right now, even in glory. Look in verse 25 now, where we just read. We stop, but look at verse 25, and it says that that they brought Jesus to the temple in 8 days. So there was a man there named Simeon there, and it says he was a just and devout man waiting for the consolation of Israel. We see that acclamation brought celebration, and we see anticipation that brings consolation. Amen. Hey, consolation. Amen. We see they were waiting on it. Amen. They were waiting on the consolation of Israel. Hey, they were waiting. The whole world was waiting for God to send a king to redeem his people. Amen. They've been waiting for 400 years of silence, they say. They were waiting on 450 prophecies of the birth of Jesus Christ to be fulfilled. Amen. I don't know about you, but that sounds like a lot of waiting right there. Hey, but they were waiting. They were anticipating this Savior that came. Amen. And he came, and Isaiah would prophesy. He was one of the prophets. He would say, hey, everybody knows what Isaiah 9 and 6 says. You probably got it on an ornament on your Christmas tree. For unto us is born. For unto us a child is born. For unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulders, and a name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Amen. And that's what Isaiah would say, prophesying. And it says that the government would be upon his shoulders. Amen. And that means the rule of this world would be upon his shoulders. The rule of his people would be upon his shoulders. And I want to say as a reminder something, that I know we're talking about Christmas, but when you talk about Christmas, you cannot get away from the cross. You can't separate the cradle and the cross. You can't do it. Amen. Matter of fact, Jesus was saying, to this end was I born. To this end I was born. Amen. Hey, and we can't separate the two. Hey, but only thing, he didn't just have the government upon his shoulders, but we know that he toted the cross of Calvary on his shoulders. Amen. Hey, and that consolation that he was waiting on was really compensation. Amen. He would die for our sins. He would pay the debt for our sins on that cross. And anticipation brought consolation. Amen. It was the payment for our sins. Let's don't ever try to separate it. Amen. Let's don't never try to separate his birth from his death. Amen. We celebrate his birth, and I enjoy doing it. But he never said celebrate his birth, but he did say celebrate his death. I'm so glad he died for you and I. I'm so glad he died for you and I. Made a way for us. Amen. We see that anticipation brought consolation. And we also see that here in verse 17 it says, and when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. Amen. Hey, look, they made it known abroad, and they had a conversation about it. I mean, they were talking about it, Brother Wayne, and the conversation brought an invitation. The conversation about Jesus brought an invitation. Hey, all through the Bible we can see where it brought invitation. Isaiah 1:18 says, "Come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as wool. Hey, though they be crimson, they shall be like wool." Amen. Hey, look, and the disciples, hey, Philip told Nathanael, he said, come and see. A conversation brings the invitation. Let me say something. You can't hardly talk about Jesus without asking somebody, have you accepted him as your personal Savior? Huh? Do you believe in Jesus Christ? Don't you believe in him? Amen. Try talking about him for 5 minutes without asking somebody, are you ready to meet him? Are you ready to meet the Lord? Remember the disciples, they told one another. The woman at the well said, come and see a man who told me everything. Amen. One of my favorite scriptures is, it was noise that Jesus was in the house, and they said that because they heard he was there, that a great multitude was in the place. Amen. A conversation would bring invitation. And all the way in the book of Revelation, you can see it says, come and see. Come and see. Talk about the Lord long enough, and there has to be an invitation. And the invitation today is still the same. If you don't know him, we've been talking about him, and you can come and see. Taste and see that the Lord, he is good. You could come and meet him today. What a great day it would be to be saved on a Christmas day. Hey, invitation was there in Revelation to come and see. Come and see. All the way through. It is, Brother Wayne, come and see. Come and see. Come and see. Say, why was it so much in there? Because in the book, he said, I'm coming. How soon is he coming, preacher? He's coming quickly. That's why we need to come unto him. Now look, I want to end like this. We see that the acclamation brought celebration. We see that the anticipation brought consolation. And we see their conversation brought invitation. But I want us to look back in verse number 1. And it says this, and it came to pass in those days that went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And I'm going to tell you something. They all had to go be taxed, and it says, and everyone had to go to their own city. And a taxation brings a migration. See, anybody like taxes? And today we can look at this, that things in our life that we don't like, things in our life that brings us pain, migrates us to Jesus Christ. See, the taxation brought migration. And I don't know what you're going through this morning. I know it's Christmas and we ought to be full of joy, and we are. But if you're going through something in your life, see, burdens bring people to Jesus Christ. Amen. Burdens bring people to Jesus Christ. The taxing of people brings them to Jesus Christ. The heavy weight, y'all remember, everybody you see in the Bible that came to Jesus was being taxed heavily. Huh? Blind Bartimaeus came to Jesus Christ. Why? Because he was blind. The woman with the issue of blood came to Jesus Christ because she had issues. Hey, she had issues. Hey, parents would come to Jesus Christ and begging for their children to be healed because their children had devils. Hey, in Matthew 15 and 30, you can see that great multitudes came unto Jesus Christ, lame, blind, dumb, and it says, and many others in the same verse. Hey, many others came. It don't matter what you've gone through, troubles and trials and taxation on our lives will migrate us towards Jesus Christ. And today on Christmas, I'm here to say, whatever you may be going through, let it bring you to him. Let that burden, that taxation on your life, let it bring you. Hey, look, bring your troubles to him. Bring your heartaches to him. Hey, bring your sins to him today. Here's what Jesus would say. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest for your weary soul. Huh? Hey, taxation will bring a migration to Jesus Christ. Brother Hunter, come get us a song of invitation. this morning. And I want to say, whatever you're going through, let it take you to Jesus Christ. Don't run away from Him. He's your only help. He's your only hope this morning. What Christmas brings, it brings a celebration, consolation, an invitation, and a migration. Help us to come unto Him. As they prepare to sing this song this morning, and we all stand all over the house of the Lord, do you know Him as your personal Savior this morning? Have you given your life unto Jesus Christ? Have you been born again? Did you ask Him to forgive you of your sin? Has He come into your life? Do you really know the reason for the season? Do you know Him as your personal Savior? As they sing this song, Brother Jay.
When I see the sunrise in the morning,
no matter what you're going through, you can bring it to Him this morning.
When I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children playing, I know it's all part of God's amazing grace. And I believe there's a place called heaven.
Do you believe it this morning?
And I believe in a place called Calvary.
I believe it this morning. I love to talk about it.
And I believe that He gave His life for me.
He was born to that end. Yes, thank you, Lord.
I was there the day my mama went to heaven. I held her hand,
yes,
as she closed her eyes to sleep. And I felt the power of 10,000 angels take her soul away to be crowned at Jesus' feet. And I believe there's a place called heaven.
It's real today, this place called heaven.
And I believe in a place called Calvary. And I believe in a man, His name is Jesus. And I
believe
that He gave His life for me.
Why don't you give Him a hand, please? Just a wave of praise this morning. Hey, the angels got excited about redemption, and they didn't even need it. We ought to be the most excited people on this earth. Amen. Sing another verse.
Brother. When I see the sunrise,
hey, think about it.
In the morning.
How does that sun come up? Because God told it to.
When I feel the wind blow across my face. When I hear the sound of children playing, I know it's all part,
thank you, Lord,
of God's amazing grace. And I believe there's a place called heaven. And I believe in a place place called Calvary. And I believe in a man, his name is Jesus. And I believe that he gave his life for me. I was there the day my mama went to heaven.
He's good to us.
I held her hand.
He's good to us.
As she closed her eyes to sleep.
He's our only hope.
And I felt the power of 10,000 angels take her soul away. To be crowned at Jesus' feet.
That's Jesus Christ that you feel right now.
And I believe there's a place called heaven. And I believe in a place called Calvary. And I believe that he gave his life for me. And I believe that he gave his life for me.
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for giving your life for us. Amen. Amen. Again, it is good to see everyone. What a great-looking congregation this morning. Brother Danny, good to have you and all the family. I know y'all going to have to be going home, but we're going to miss you, brother. Amen. We could get used to y'all being here. Amen. And we love y'all. Been praying for you. We'll continue to do that. Good to see Jennifer back there with us. Amen. Hey, Jennifer. Good to see you. Good to have all our visitors. Good to have my baby girl back in town. Amen. And Thomas. Amen. Good to see everyone in the house of the Lord this morning. Merry Christmas. And we love you all. If we ever can do anything for you, please let us know. And let's remember a few announcements that we will be back on Wednesday night, our regular service. No service tonight, but we will be back Wednesday night. And remember this. And also, Saturday morning, New Year's Eve, Saturday morning at 11 o'clock, we're going to start our 24-hour prayer chain. You say, what is this, preacher? Well, we're coming to the church. Just sign up. They got a sheet back there in the back. Sign up for an hour. And what you need to do is just come, try to be here, make sure you're here at 5 minutes before at least. Pray with those who's praying. Come and kneel down and start praying for your hour. Someone will come and relieve you in an hour. And we're going to keep this going for 24 hours. We do not want an hour to go missed. Amen. If you have not signed up, the paper's on the back, please sign up. I need some men to take some more of those midnight hours through the wee hours of the morning. They still open. Please sign your name in these and take these. And let's get this done. Amen. We got enough people, we could have a whole lot more than 24 hours of prayer.
Yeah. Right.
Amen. So let's get these filled in. Amen. Write a name down or many names as you'd like on a piece of paper. Prayer box is right here. Drop it in there today, Wednesday night, and it'll be opened up and poured out on the altar, and it'll give you will run out of time in an hour if you really get to praying. An hour will go by just like that. Just remember this. Amen. Any other announcements? I might need some help. They're ganging up.
Sister Michelle. You'll stand there with you. We just got gifts from the church we wanted to give them. We appreciate them.
Amen.
All year, not just today. And I know we give them gifts and stuff, but we appreciate them. We try to show them every day. Anytime we're around them, show them how much we love them and appreciate them. So I hope everybody tries to show that. I want them to go ahead and open them and get their face red and all that stuff. Love y'all. Hope everybody has a Merry Christmas. Y'all, please be safe with everything you do and spread the love of Jesus everywhere you go. If there's nothing else, I'm going to ask Brother Norman if he'll dismiss us in prayer.